What is up, YouTube? PokeStrats TCG bringing you another Pokemon TCG video. And today I'm going to be talking about the best ways to get get the cards you want in Pokemon TCG Online. How to just grind and the fastest way to just get the cards you want without having to spend real money, mainly just in-game stuff. You just gotta do it the right way. It does take a lot longer than obviously just straight up spending money, but you'll get the cards you want, and you will. You just gotta grind a lot. You gotta play every day. Can't miss a day. You don't have to play all day, but you just gotta play at least a couple hours every day. And you will probably get the stuff you want. It will happen for sure. You just gotta be patient, gotta grind a lot, and you will get it. I'm gonna show you guys how to get the cards you want in the game and grind for the cards. Alright, first of all, the first thing you need to make sure you do to get yourself one step closer to having your standard deck, I'm gonna be talking about mainly standard, because I focus more on standard. I play standard. That's mainly what I'm about. I don't play expanded. So to get standard deck, you want, what you first want to make sure you do, especially if you're new to Pokemon TCG Online, this is also for new people that don't really know what to do, and they just want to get the deck they want, but they don't know how to do it and grind for the cards. First thing you want to make sure you do, trainer challenge. Say you just started playing Pokemon TCG Online. You don't have anything. You're freshly new. You're going to have these three starter theme decks. And you're not going to be on City Championship yet. You're going to be gold, because you haven't done this before. These three decks, the Moltres deck, the Zapdos deck, the Articuno deck, these are going to be the decks that are provided for you to start off with. And they're gonna give them to you so you can battle every single one of these trainers in this tournament to try and beat them. And every time you beat them with one of these decks, you'll get one star. And if for every theme deck that you beat them, you'll get a star. You just gotta make sure you play with a different structure deck. I really like Hidden Depths, so I'm gonna play all of them four times with Hidden Depths, try to get four stars. You'll get one star because you beat them. You beat them all with one of these structure decks, but you won't get four. To get four, you have to beat them all once with Crushing Current as well, with all once with Born of Fire, and one other structure deck. And you won't have. Unfortunately, they won't give you a fourth structure deck, so you have to buy a structure deck in the store. And I'm definitely gonna make a video on the best decks to buy. They're gonna give you the most wins when playing theme battles. So that way, because the only way to get coins and prizes is to win. So I'm definitely gonna be talking about the best ones to buy that are gonna give you the most wins and the most value out of your buck. But yeah, you wanna buy mainly the new ones. And just buy one of them. You don't have to buy a lot. Just buy one of these structure decks, and you will be chilling. You'll be able to play theme battles now with the good deck. You could necessarily play with the structure decks that you they provide you with, but they're honestly really, really bad. They're not going to be able to compete in theme battles against other people playing the much better, newer theme decks, structure decks, whatever you want to call it. So, just complete this, complete gold, complete platinum, complete city championship. You'll get a lot of packs from completing all these. You'll get a lot of standard packs, a lot. It'll take a lot of time. It'll be pretty boring, but you'll get an insane amount of packs that'll definitely help you get one step closer to building your deck and getting you a lot of cards. And then second way you you want to do is you want to be here every single day. You want to be going on the versus ladder all the time. There's two ways where you'll get prizes. First off is the daily rewards. It opens from 5 o'clock p.m. to, and then the new daily reward starts the next day at 5 o'clock p.m. There's a 24 hours range between 5 o'clock p.m. to the next day, 5 o'clock p.m. Basically, 5 o'clock p.m. is when the new daily reward starts. So you want to make sure you finish all your daily versus rewards before 5 o'clock p.m. because then that's when the new versus reward starts. And basically, you have a lot of prizes every day. And basically, 12 wins. Once you do your 12 wins, there really isn't much you get. You only get like 5 coins after that. I mean, if you want to grind for 5 coins and just keep getting 5 coins, that's fine. But honestly, I'd recommend winning, just doing, getting 11 wins every single day, getting these done, and then waiting for the next daily versus rewards to start, getting 11 wins, and repeating, rinse and repeating every day, just to get your daily rewards in, and then go for the next daily rewards that come out. And then doing that every single day, trust me, it'll add up. You'll get a lot of coins. As you guys have seen, I have a lot of coins because I play every day. I get my 12 wins. I don't even play a lot of events, really. As you guys have seen, I have a lot of tickets because I don't play events. I just play the ladder. And the ladder honestly gives me a lot of coins. And just playing the ladders. And the coins, they let you buy packs as well, which also help you can help you build your deck, because you'll be able to have chances at pulling the cards you want. But I don't want to get off topic. This video is about how to get cards and the cards you want as fast as possible, and what to do. Second thing in the versus that you'll get playing the ladder is you also get, not daily, you also be able to do the monthly rewards, which is the same thing, except you can try to get these rewards as much as you want. You can complete these monthly rewards in one day. If you play all day and get a lot of wins, you can complete this whole monthly, all these monthly rewards in one day. I don't recommend that though, but I'm just saying that it won't go away like the dailies. You'll have a whole month to try to get all these rewards, which is a lot of time. And the more you win, the more higher your lightning score will go. The lightning score is basically like the points you get from winning, and it varies on how the skill level of the players you beat. Say you beat a more advanced player that's has a lot of wins, a higher skill level, your lightning score will go up a lot higher if you beat them. And if you beat a player that isn't too high in skill level, your lightning level will increase a little bit, not as high. So that's how you kind of tell how it can go up fast or not. Also, win streaks. The more higher your win streaks are, the more your lightning score will increase. So basically, try to get win streaks, because that'll make your lightning score increase a lot. Since I don't mean to brag, but since I usually win a lot, and I usually have high win streaks, that's usually why I'm able to finish this off real fast. And that could be you too. So definitely try to do this. You get a lot of good rewards, coins, packs, special cards, a treasure chest, tickets. And I'm going to talk about the tickets right after this, because the tickets are really important. Packs, big treasure chests, more packs, more coins, more tickets. The monthlies are broken. Definitely want to complete the monthlies every month. So like I said, you doing the dailies, the monthlies, staying consistent with them, it'll really add up. Trust me, it'll really, really add up, and you'll be much closer and closer and closer to getting the cards that you need for your deck. And that way you can play standard or expanded, whatever you want, This method though is more opposed to standard. Okay, now we're gonna go on to tickets. Like I said, I want to talk about tickets. You're probably like, what do tickets do? Okay, well this is where you want to go to use your tickets. First off, let me break it down. For theme battles, if you want to play a theme battle tournament, 4 tickets it costs. For an expanded theme battle tournament, or no, for an expanded format tournament, it costs 8 tickets. For a standard format tournament, 8 tickets as well. Basically, what it is it's a to enter, say you want to enter a theme battle tournament. It's 4 tickets, and basically, you play 3 rounds, best of 1, and it's single elimination, so you just gotta win out. And basically, the placing you finish, you'll get a certain amount of prizes. It's really, really cool. So, you know, this is pretty much it. 5th through 8th, you just get a 1 uncommon chest. 3rd through 4th, you get 1 pack, a random standard booster, 50 tokens, trainer tokens, not bad. 2nd place, you get 1 Rebel Clash pack, right now, that's what it is. 1 random standard booster, 100 trainer coins, a little bit better, for sure, much better. And then 1st place, obviously, even better rewards, 2 Rebel Clash packs, 1 random standard booster, 200 coins, which 200 coins straight up buys you a pack, any pack you want. And yeah, this is really, really broken. It gives you a chance to get packs. And the really cool thing about these packs, and particularly compared to the daily reward packs and the monthly packs, is these packs that you get from here are tradable packs, which is really, really, really just broken. This is how you're going to guarantee you getting the specific cards you want for your deck. And it's the same thing for with standard expanded, except standard costs 8 more tickets, but the prizes are a lot better. You get 1st, you get 6 packs, 400 coins. Like, it's just the prizes are double, like way better. It costs more, but the prizes are doubled. So it's the same thing essentially. It's just a little more scarier to enter because it is a hefty more amount of tickets. But this is the way to go. This is why I recommend trying to grind for tickets, just try to play these tournaments. Like I said, if you don't have the deck you want, start off with the theme tournaments. It's only 4 tickets, so you'll be able to play a lot of them and just try to win. Get 2nd, 3rd, just try not to get last, and you'll be getting packs over and over and over again. And just don't open those packs. The packs you get from here, don't open them. I recommend trading them for the cards you want, unless you don't need any cards and you just want to open packs. More power to you. But if you want to get cards for your deck, the best way is to get as many packs from here, and those packs you get from here, trade them for cards you want. And then you want to go here and basically say you got some packs, Rebel Clash for example, and you have a good amount of packs. Basically what you want to do is you want to put packs, or you just put a card you want. Say you want, I'm just gonna do like just an example. Say you want a Zacian B. So you're gonna filter it, put cards, put I'm getting, this is incorrect. You want a Zacian V. Maybe you want 2. But let's use Zacian V as an example. Say you want a Zacian V. Basically, you putting Zacian V is gonna filter out all the Zacian Vs people are trading. And say we click on this Zacian V, he's giving a Zacian V, but he wants 16 Rebel Clash packs. This honestly isn't a good deal because Zacian isn't worth that much. or maybe it is now, I'm not sure, I haven't looked into the market for Zacian, but since you, I have 19 tradable packs, I can trade these packs for a straight up Zacian, and I'll have the Zacian for my deck, or whatever card you want, you'll have it straight away. That's why these packs, the events are really, really important, and you need to play them and try to get those tickets so you can play them, so that way you can get, you can be able to just trade for cards you want, and it's gonna be worth it for sure. Honestly, you can't get the cards you want if you don't play events at all. You need to play events, you just have to, and that is how you do it. Honestly, you just, that is pretty much how it works for sure. And last thing we'll talk about, another way to get more coins and packs is just doing the daily challenges. It'll tell you certain things every day. Like, I have these for my dailies. I really don't do them because I just don't, I'm not hungry for coins and packs, because I pretty much have a lot of the cards I need now, because I've grinded a lot. But if you really are hungry for coins and packs, and you want to increase your chances even more to get cards faster and packs faster, which can be cards you need, do these every single day. They'll open up, there'll be new challenges every day, but you got to complete them. If you don't complete them, you won't get any more challenges. You have to complete these challenges to get new ones. And yeah, like right here, there's knockout 12 opposing water Pokemon, get a pack. The next one, put 7 evolution lightning Pokemon cards in play, you get 55 coins. That's halfway to a pack, to buying a pack. Next one, knock out 16 opposing Pokemon with your fire Pokemon. You knock out 16 total, you get a pack. Like, it's just, you gotta do all these things. To just keep getting more and more packs, coins, and it, like I said, it's just gonna add up. You just gotta grind, do the right stuff, and the best way to do this, to do all these things, is getting either a theme battle, different theme decks, or just building like a standard deck with what you have, and just trying to use, just do what it says. And I think I'm just gonna wrap it up. I think I've covered everything I have to cover for how to get the cards you want, and how to just grind for Pokecoins, tickets, and packs. They're pretty much all the ways, really. These are all the ways you can do it. If you don't know what to do, this is how you, those are the ways on how you get coins, packs, tickets, tradable packs, etc. And I hope this helped you guys out. If you have any more questions about this topic, leave a comment. Definitely be more than happy to help answer your guys' questions. And I'm gonna be posting more helpful videos like this. Next video I'm gonna be posting is the best theme decks to buy currently to try to get a lot of wins. And the easiest ones as well to play that are good as well. So yeah, I think that's it. Like I said, I hope it helped you out. Try this out, it's gonna work. It'll take time, it'll definitely take time, but guarantee if you do this consistently, you will get the cards you want. You'll get the stuff, you'll get that deck that you've been wanting to play, and you'll be good from then on. You'll be able to just kind of keep, you'll be able to get more, different decks a lot easier. The beginning is the hardest part, though. It is the hardest part, because you don't have anything, and you have to just build up a foundation and build up a lot of cards. So yeah, all right guys, I think I'm signing out. Peace.